We're on the show floor of TU Auto. It's day one. We are among some of the automotive technology companies that are changing the future of how we're all going to get around. And we're going to go talk to some people right now and see what's going on. Does this level of control stop with the garage door, or can it connect to other devices in the home?
It can. So right now we actually have lights. So if I go ahead and I go to, let's say, my living room here, I can turn that light on.
I did what is called remote code execution. I executed the code into his car remotely, and now it's actually under my control. But I could also accelerate like crazy.
Whoa!
You see here, everything looks exactly the same for the hacker's perspective. And when he's doing the hack, The hack was actually prevented.
Guys, what are some of the major trends that we're seeing at the event this year?
Before, when I first started coming to TU events years ago, it was all about the connected car. Now, the ecosystem has spread out to include artificial intelligence, IoT, smart cities, facial recognition, for example. If you had told me 10 years ago that you would see, I don't know, an AI company here or that type of thing, you know, it wouldn't have been possible. But now, as we're seeing this whole convergence around technology at large and the car in particular, it's just exciting. It's so many different things happening.
Is the car like the smartphone, or is it a different story than the smartphone? Obviously, Android is a common platform, but we also know that, you know, it can be a problem with, from security perspectives. You know, you got Apple wanting to play in that role.
One of the things that auto manufacturers are balancing right now is, on the one hand, wanting to create a unique branded experience that their customers are used to. On the other hand, there's a trend towards having something that's a little bit more standardized, like an Android automotive. How do you balance that in the work that you do?
It's an excellent question, and actually I think that the smartphone analogy is a great one, because I mean, 10, 15 years ago, every single smartphone OEM had their own user interface. And now we see that the same kind of shift that we saw 10, 15 years ago in the smartphone industry is happening in the automotive industry.
Do you think that we're heading towards a place where the experience between different kinds of cars is going to become a little bit more flat, in the sense of how cars are being designed?
It's a very sort of dangerous and tricky question.
Sure.
From an OEM perspective,
right.
But I do think that we're headed down that path. So we have chosen to partner up with Google to be the first ones to bring a fully automotive grade Android experience into the car with Google services fully integrated.